the very difficult situation nowadays. So I am going to COVID pandemic, how to maintain yourself during COVID pandemic or even away from this COVID pandemic. My topic is related that what will happen after this COVID pandemic goes away. When the COVID pandemic is over, what is our duty? What that to be do? We need to do to maintain our body, to maintain our fitness, to maintain our mental ability and all. Control, next slide. Next slide. The purpose of the topic to explain the main type of exercise and their benefits on after effect of COVID pandemic. They have lots of exercise. And what are the benefits on the after effect of COVID pandemic? I will talk of that. The next purpose is physiological effect of exercise on the after effect of COVID pandemic. Next slide. Why exercise is so important? Nowadays, that our body is a functional body and we need our body to be fit, and this is what health is. This is the foundation of our health. If the body is fit, then we are having a good health. That's what we expect from our exercise. If we do exercise, our body will function properly and we will remain fit forever. Exercise is the only way to get in shape. Exercise helps you to be in shape internally as well as externally of the body. Without health, there is no happiness. We know that if health is there, then there is happiness. Health is wealth in food medicine. This quote is being said by Thomas Jefferson. Next slide. What is exercise and time? We know exercise is a repeated rhythmic movement. Repeated rhythmic movement means we do every kind of work, household work. We go here and there, we take bath, we do physical movement, we go to market. And this helps your body parts to do the physical exercise. And it will help, rather it will help in remain healthy and it will develop your body parts. Exercise improves this kind of body parts through exercise. Short time exercise. The times of short time exercise, if we do exercise for at least 30 minutes at the rate of 1 kilocalorie per minute, we can say that it is short time exercise. Long term exercise, if exercise is performed daily for 30 minutes at the rate of 1 kilocalorie energy per minute for 5 days per week forever, then it is called long term exercise. Next. Next slide, Shantanu. Main type of purposeful exercise. We have different types of exercise. We call aerobic exercise. We know aerobics. Aerobics is not a term. Aerobic is a process. That is, exercise is done with oxygen, in presence of oxygen. That is continuous exercise with elevated oxygen. And anaerobic is exercise which is done without oxygen. That is deadlifting, power exercise. In this anaerobic exercise, oxygen demand is greater than the oxygen supply by the body. We do force training exercise as anaerobic exercise, stability training, flexibility training, balance training, force specific training, that is agility and performance. Next slide. Next slide. Shantanu, next slide. What is fitness?
Yes, yes.
Yes. What is fitness? We know what fitness is. Fitness is what? To do physical work through long duration without any fatigue. if we can do physical exercise for long duration of time and without any fatigue, with involving musculoskeletal and different system of the body, then we say that we are having a good fitness. If we have true fitness with greater degree, then there is reduce risk of various type of disease. And if we do exercise, we will have a sense of well-being and functionality in our life. Restfully with proper sleep, sound sleep, delay aging related physiological changes. Delay aging means within a very small age you become aged. What is that aged? The toning of the muscle goes down. The calcium part is very low. Due to exercise, this process can be delayed. Patient asks, why exercise? Why we should do exercise? Exercise make you feel better. Exercise makes you look better. You look better through exercise. Exercise make you feel better about yourself, what you are. That shows you to exercise, reduce risk of other diseases, cancer, lead to improvement in great variety of disease and negative health conditions. Exercise will not allow any negative health condition. Next slide. Next slide. Santanu, next slide.
Yes, sir.
Sadhastar, sir.
Exercise physiology and its specific benefit. We will discuss about the physiology and its specific benefit. Different systems, that is cardiovascular, respiratory, endocrine, musculoskeletal and overall body composition and mental health. Next slide. Next slide, sir. Thank you. Cardiovascular benefit, the sustained exercise program. This is the exercise. If you do
ভালো নেট কানেকশন হতে হবে ভালো হয় নাকি আমার যদি ফোনে কথা বলি জিওটা ওকে
Lower LDL is potentially
low. Sure, yeah.
The recommended
কি করে ইন্টারন্যাশনাল লেভেল তো
exercise for a long duration,
one month,
it will have this kind of effect. Fitness will
look
and work for longer duration. Ability, your circulation of the blood will
increase.
The heart muscle enlarged means stroke volume will
increase,
resulting in stroke volume.
কন্ট্রোলে বাইরে চলে যাবে
for on is 45 see how much is on now and the rest of this problem for 70
minutes
maximum world class athlete it is 136 problem see how much amount of blood is pumped for the world class athlete due to exercise and the maximum is 184 ml per beat next slide Next slide. The cardiac output, the resting sedentary man is 6.1, maximum is 17.7. But world class athlete is 6.1 resting, and 35 liter per minute is for the world class. What is cardiac output? Amount of blood pumped out by the heart in 1 minute. This is the liter, 35 liter maximum. Arteriovenous O2 difference. What is arteriovenous O2 difference? Oxygen content of blood between arterial blood and venous blood. It is an indication of how much oxygen is removed from the blood. It is an indication of how much oxygen is removed from the blood to capillaries and tissues as the blood circulates in the body. Here, the sedentary man is 4 and maximum 14.2 ml per deciliter blood. For world-class athlete, it is 4, resting. But maximum is 16 ml per deciliter blood. Next slide. Respiratory system, the lung volume increase. The lung volume increase means the amount of blood inside the lung that he can inhale is increased to excess. Breathing frequency decrease. Breathing frequency is number of beats per minute. It will decrease. Maximum minute ventilation increase means how much of amount of air you breathe in 1 minute. It will increase in 1 minute. It will take lots of blood, plenty of air inside. Tidal volume increase. What is tidal volume? It is the amount of air in and out of the lung in one respiratory cycle. Amount of air in and out of the lung in one respiratory cycle means inhalation and exhalation. What is ventilatory efficiency increase? What is ventilatory efficiency? Ventilatory efficiency is the relationship between minute ventilation and carbon dioxide production. It is diffusion capacity, and it indicates the transfer of gas from air into the lung, into the red blood cell in the lung blood vessel. That means how much gases from the air is transferred into the lung. That is the diffusion capacity. It is increased. Blood flow around heart in body. Exercise and the musculoskeleton. Size of the muscle fiber increase. Muscle fiber doesn't increase lengthwise. It increases in the cross-sectional way. Means hypertrophy. Myoglobin content increase. Myoglobin is present in muscles, and due to exercise, this myoglobin content increases. Blood supply in the muscle. Number of mitochondria increases. That is, mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell, which supply energy to the cell. Total and relative fat increases. Relative fat is, what is relative fat? Ratio of fat mass to total body mass, which is expressed in percentage. That is, decrease. Fat-free mass increases. Your body weight will increase, but fat mass will not increase. Flexibility will increase. Next slide. Exercise and the musculoskeletal system. Strain for resistance training, that is weightlifting, lead to greater muscle mass. If you do strength training exercise or resistance exercise, your muscle mass will improve. That means muscle hypertrophy will come. Lead to increase overall strength. Exercise will develop your overall strength, that is power, joint stability, the joint will be stable, muscle metabolism, can also improve neuromuscular control. Neuromuscular control is that the motor neurons transfer impulses to the nerve fiber. This function is bit for faster to exercise. Exercise and mental health. Exercise promotes positive changes in mood. Your mood will change, increase brain blood flow. Blood flow increase in nerve growth factor, increase concentration and neurotransmitter. What is neurotransmitter? Neurotransmitter is the substance which neurons use to communicate with one another. It transfers the impulses to the nerve fiber and tissue fiber. These are what that dopamine, glutamate, norepinephrine, serotonin. These are the neurotransmitters which are increased due to exercise. Release of opioid-like endorphin. But this opioid is one type of drugs which are used to reduce pain and boost pleasure means feeling of euphoria. Runner side, if you are doing your severe exercise and you complete it successfully, then you are having a feeling of euphoria. And this euphoria is due to the release of endorphins, that is opioid. Next slide. Exercise is very effective treatment for depression. Exercise will help you to release from depression, improve in serotonin level, that is neurotransmitter. It will help you to lose your weight, increase confidence and self-worth, improvement in other mental disorders. Disorder will be lessened down. Improve cognition in dementia. What is dementia? Loss of memory. Slowly, exercise can help to recover your loss of memory. Stress reduction in anxiety state. What is stress? It is triggered by an event. Event means, say, exam phobia. When exam phobia comes, it is a stress for you. And to release this stress and reaction to this stress, we have anxiety. Means due to exam, we are having fear that will fail or pass. And this is what we call anxiety. Exercise and sleep. Exercise improves ability to fall asleep and remain asleep. Exercise helps you to get proper sleep. When the physical body is exhausted, it sleeps in REM, the rapid eye movement, or rapid eye movement, severe activity. You can sleep during rapid eye movement or a longer period. Muscle recovery during sleep and rapid eye movement helps lead to more restful sleep and increase energy during the day. It will help you to increase the energy. Mind, what is that? Mind, that may be helped by exercise. family, then why should we go for crime? Next slide. Next slide. These are the recommendations for exercise under 65 years of age, adult, moderate intensity for 30 minutes, 5 times per week, or high intensity exercise for 20 minutes, 3 times per week, and 8 to 10 repetition of 10 strengthening exercise 2 times per week. Next. Next slide. This is exercise recommendation for adults over 65 years of age. Moderate intensity exercise for 5 times per week, or high intensity exercise for 20 minutes, 3 times per week, and 10 to 15 repetition of strengthening exercise 2 times per week, and in extra balance training if you are having the symptoms of falling. Next slide. Physical activity guidelines for everyone. Do moderate intensity exercise for 30 minutes 5 times per week, or high intensity exercise for 20 minutes 3 times per week, or combination of moderate and high intensity exercise to reach the recommended level as per your level. Next. These are the sources from where I got the information. Next slide. Next slide. Next slide. Thank you. Thank you, Shantanu, and thank you, Taradasha Degree College and the College Organizing Committee, IQS, for giving me a chance to speak in this webinar. I'm sorry for the technical issue on a case to me, and I am very thankful to you all for inviting me for this seminar. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your nice presentation. Now it is for question and answer discussion session. So, any questions?
Sir, myself.
Sundeep, sir. Any questions?
Hello.
Pradipto.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Pradipto. You can speak.
Sir, you have recommended some exercises. For this COVID situation or the after COVID situation?
After COVID. I am talking about...
We will do? So what we will do in COVID situation, sir?
Sir, Pradipto, I have spoken in the beginning that if this webinar is about after effect of COVID, after effect, that's why in many seminar I have talked about the present situation. Is I have talked about that if COVID somehow goes from our society, then how to manage our physical body after this COVID pandemic. But yes, exercise you have to continue throughout this COVID pandemic, but it is not possible to go out and do physical exercise. Yes. My recommendation is after the COVID, please go outside, do moderate training, do intensive training, so that you can go out and do different type of activities. But in home, you can't do different type of activities. That is
Yes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Hello?
Any questions?
No, sir.